Check your hair. And five, four, three, two, one, and live. Good luck.
Merhaba arkadaşlar, hepiniz IFT Talks webinarlarına hoş geldiniz. Bugün İrlanda'nın ilk ve en iyi üniversitesi Trinity College Dublin'de eğitim ve İrlanda'da kariyer fırsatlarını Antonio'dan dinliyor olacağız. Lütfen sorularınızı questions kısmından sormayı unutmayın. Yes, Antonio, the stage is yours now.
Zeynep, thank you very much. And it's a pleasure to be back again at the Talks with IFT. Thank you for everybody, to everybody for joining. And I really hope to have the opportunity to see you sooner rather than later again back in Turkey, a country I love so much. And I miss so much my visits over there. So I'm going to start sharing my screen to go through the presentation. And I will give you a brief introduction of what you can expect during this afternoon. Let me see. Here you are, and you should be here. During this presentation, as you know, is mainly focused on students that want to do a master's in Trinity. But very important as well as to know in relation to the programs that Trinity has to offer, the university itself. I will also give you an introduction about Ireland, about Dublin, because everything counts when it comes to make a very exciting but sometimes challenging decision, which is to study a program abroad in a different country, in a different culture. I will talk also about the opportunities that you will have when you graduate from Trinity, from an Irish university, in terms of jobs and how are the type of companies that you can try to work for if you decided to stay in Ireland. Without further ado, I want to play a short video on Trinity, where you will get a little bit of a feeling of what Trinity College is about.
Antonio, we cannot hear the sound. Could you please turn it on?
So it seems that you cannot hear the song, but can you hear me now, Zeynep?
Yes. Are you using earphones?
I'm using earphones. Yeah, I do. But let me try. If you just bear with me 1 second, I'm going to stop sharing the screen. Okay, and I'm going to retry it again and to see how it works. Apologies about this. Let me disable the screen. And I think there is a function there that maybe I haven't check before. Yeah, it's share the audio system. So now it should be okay. Thank you so much and apologies. But now I have to open the presentation. So you're going to, all of you, you're going to see all my messy desktop here. But that's something that happened with when you are live. But let me see. Here you are. And that should be okay. So we try again, and that should be totally fine. Let's go.
Inspiration has lived here since 1592, and more than 400 years later, it's still going strong. Inspiration has helped burgeoning writers put pen to paper and given world leaders a head start. It has set the stage for budding playwrights and creative characters that will never die. For countless actors who started here, inspiration has played a part. Work done in Trinity helps split the atom, battled cancer, and guided man's first giant leap. From here, we've inspired people around the world. But even with this proud history, we are firmly focused on the future. Today, we are making new discoveries and inspiring the next generation of history makers.
So So I hope that you have enjoyed this video. But by the way, pretty much everybody involved in the production of the video was something to do with Trinity. The voice, if you recognize it, is a famous actress, Ruth Negan, that she was a Trinity student. And the music, actually, by Hozier. Hozier was also a Trinity student as well. And that has been a constant in the history of Trinity College. We have been around for more than 400 years, and since then we have people like Jonathan Swift, the famous writer of the Gulliver Travels, or Oscar Wilde, probably the second most famous writer in English after William Shakespeare. Ernest Walton, Nobel Prize in Physics, and also a professor for many years in Trinity as well. Samuel Beckett, Nobel Prize in Drama. William Campbell, Nobel Prize in Medicine, although he studies zoology, biological and biomedical science. Mary Robinson and Mary Magalies, the two only women that they have been president of Ireland, both of them graduate from our School of Law, and actually Mary Robinson was also the High Commissioner for Human Rights in the United Nations. Sally Rooney, one of the most famous writers now of her age. She only turned 30, and you probably have seen one of her books in a TV show format called Normal People. Jack Gleeson, he is a famous actor. He was in Game of Thrones. He was a Trinity graduate as well. And after his experience in Trinity, instead of becoming an evil king, it seems that he wants to pursue an academic career. I hope that in a few years I can put a picture of you in that presentation when I go back to Turkey. Trinity, when people look at the university, what strikes them is many things. One of them is obviously our long and prestigious history. It was founded in 1592 by the Queen Elizabeth I when Ireland used to be part of the United Kingdom. It's one of the seven ancient universities in the English-speaking world. It was modeled after Cambridge and Oxford. And nowadays is the only of the seven that is in the European Union, and also the only one of the seven that has a full historical campus in a city, in this case, in the capital of Ireland, in Dublin. It's a beautiful university. I don't know if you have been in Dublin, but if you have, you have no chance to miss Trinity. It's right in the middle of the heart of Dublin, and it's full of beautiful buildings, alternating with very modern buildings as well. This is the main gate. On the right-hand side, you have Grafton Street. In the middle, Dame Street, and on the other side, O'Connell Street. They are the three main avenues of Dublin City. This is the beginning of the campus. You go through the main gate on the right-hand side, where you can see those columns. There is my office. So if you ever come to Dublin, don't hesitate to contact me and we can have a coffee and chat about Trinity. Although the coffee, I have to say, that is not as nice as the Turkish coffee I have every time I go to your country. We have many beautiful buildings. Like this one is we call it museum building. It's not a museum, it's part of the School of Engineering, but we call it museum just because it's stunning. Oh, this is the Business School, which is a very state-of-the-art new building, only opened a couple of years ago. Our library, one of the most famous libraries in the world. This will be the equivalent in terms of a tourist attraction of Hagia Sophia for people that come to Dublin. But the beautiful thing about the library is not just that it's stunning and it's almost 300 years old, but the beautiful thing is that it's a functioning library. It's not only open as a museum for tourists that they want to enjoy this fabulous space. It's open to every single student in Trinity, that they can access to all the modern libraries, and also they all want to check these old books if they need it for their research and their studies. We have many books because we are the only university that we are legal deposit since 1801, which means that every single book that has been published for the last 200 years in England, Wales, Scotland, or Ireland, we have to have a copy. The location is extremely unique. You can see the campus of Trinity around there. And that's really right in the middle of the city center, but also very close to the sea that you can see at the top of this picture, and very close to the mountains, the Dublin Mountains, on the right-hand side. What do you expect about Ireland? It's a country that is extremely well located. It's very obviously, it's part of the European Union, it's part of Europe, so you have no problem to access anywhere into Europe. Also with direct flights into Istanbul, and very short trip as well if you want to go to the US. It's a small country. The population is not very big. We are talking about 5 million people. The last time I checked in Istanbul, between registered inhabitants and non-registered, I believe that you have around 20,000 people only in Istanbul. The population of Ireland is not even a quarter of that. And actually, around the half of it is in Dublin. Ireland is very well known as an extremely friendly country, very welcoming people. And in my opinion, I believe it's because Ireland has a long tradition of emigration, so they know how complicated at the beginning can be to change country, to change culture. So they like to reciprocate and to make everybody feel at home. And in one case of that, of a foreigner that one day went to Ireland with the idea to stay 6 months, and I have been there, have been here for almost 16 years now. Is the main English-speaking country in the European Union. There is a very long tradition in education, and obviously Trinity is a good sample of that. The currency is the euro, very convenient when you compare it with other currencies like the pound. And this friendliness of Irish people is reflected in many things. And one of them is the regulations for immigration. All students in Ireland for undergrad and postgraduate, they can benefit from this stay back visa. Today we are talking about postgraduates, and it's particularly interesting. If you come to Trinity to study 1 year as a master's student, you have the option to stay 2 years afterward to look for a job. Then you can take it or you cannot take it, but for me it's the way of Ireland telling you, you are welcome, we want to have you here. So if you decided, you can stay with us, which is a nice thing when you are outside of your country. And also it's very strategic as well, because if you stay working in Ireland for 5 years, you can apply for a residency. So you can become a citizen of Ireland and by extension, a citizen of the European Union. So that completely expands your opportunities to develop your career and your personal life in any country within the European Union. And all these opportunities is combined with the fact that Ireland has become in the last 25 years, the so-called Silicon Valley of Europe, which means that most of the major multinationals in the IT sector, computer science, banking services, pharmaceutical companies, they have the headquarters for Europe in Ireland. And particularly I love when I come to Turkey, because many of these companies, they have the headquarters for Turkey as well. So basically, nowadays, if you come to study a master's in Trinity College, which is the top university in the country and one of the top universities in the world, you study something that you can link to this industry, and you're Turkish and you have the stay back visa, it's a fantastic combination. And at these companies, you may find all sort of departments, because you may say, well, I want to study law. So Google, Apple, Microsoft maybe are not the type of companies. And that's not true, because they have legal department as well as they have finance departments. So all these multinationals, they have all sort of departments that open a lot of opportunities for people to work with them. If we talk about Dublin, again, it's a European capital, but it's a small capital, which I love it because make Dublin extremely friendly. It's a very dynamic, with people from absolutely everywhere, very multicultural, but at the same time, it's not an overwhelming city. We are talking about 1.5 million people, and it's still one of the safest cities in the world. So you have everything that you expect in a European capital, but you don't have to spend your life commuting from one place to another. You don't have to plan ahead to go for a concert for 2 months. There is a lot of things to do, and all of them, they are really at hand. And that's why students in the world, they usually rate Dublin as one of the preferred destinations to study. You have Dublin as a technological hub. Many of the companies that I was mentioning before that they are in Ireland, they are actually in Dublin. We have a long tradition in culture. Many writers, many of them coming from Trinity, were born in Dublin. It's extremely well connected with Ireland, with Europe, and with the US as well. And you can just imagine the best, and that's what you get in terms of the opportunities for restaurants, museums, theaters, anything that you can imagine, you have it around the corner. And Trinity is, as I say, at the heart of Dublin. That means that you will have a very lively student experience with many things to do within the walls of the campus. But as soon as you get out, you have everything that Dublin has to offer to you. Among all these things, all these multinationals, that we have a lot of synergy with them, not only because of the prestige of Trinity and being the top university in the country, but also because of close proximity. So basically, we are physically very close to each other. In Trinity, everything that we do is linked to research. It's a research-intensive university. And this is also as well seen when you study as a master's student. We are talking about top masters for a year, but still many programs, they will require a final piece of research, a final project that you have the opportunity to develop these skills, because that is what helps us to push our students, our academics, to be always around one of the best universities in the world. And this is Trinity. It's always a mix between the historic, the old, so you can see the library there, and the new research that we carried away that is seminal for in many fields around the world. And you can see one of the many different modern buildings that we also have on campus as well. When you come to Trinity, something that you will notice from the very first day is that you will have a very international experience. Trinity is the eighth most international university in the world. And you can see that in every single way. For instance, if we talk about the student population, we have nowadays more than 120 different nationalities on campus. That means that when you come to our campus, you will have the opportunity to meet Turkish people, but obviously Irish people and people from absolutely everywhere. That makes Trinity very distinctive, because there are universities that they say that they have a lot of international students, but they may have only people from one particular country. When you come to Trinity, you will have people from the US, from China, from India, from everywhere in the Middle East and North Africa, from Southeast Asia, from absolutely everywhere. And also our academics, 40% of our academics are from outside of Ireland, which makes our academic body the most diverse in Europe as well. Since Trinity was founded in 1592, has been the top university in Ireland and also one of the best universities in the world. We are always around the top 100 best universities in the world. Something that is very particular about Trinity is that we are extremely good at being innovative and entrepreneurial. In the last 6 years, every single year, Trinity has been ranked as the most entrepreneurial university in Europe, because we produce more entrepreneurs than any other university in Europe. And you may think, what is this to do with me if I may want to study engineering, or I may want to study law, psychology, no business? And this is something that we consider is crucial, because the reality is we're living with COVID now, but when it's not COVID, there is a crisis with the oil, there is a war, there is always something. And we cannot foresee what is going to happen in 3, 4, 5 years' time. So master programs that you study now that have a lot of potential, that potential may change in 3, 4 years. So we want to make sure that our students thrive whatever they study. And how we do that? We have an innovation center that is open to all our students, doesn't matter what you study. And if you have an idea, you can come there. And if the idea has potential, we will help you to develop it. And if it's very good, you may get seed money from Trinity to start your company. You may get a place in our incubator. And that's how we are helping to our students to make sure that in whatever circumstances, they find the career pathway that they love. And to make sure that happens is not only the Innovation Center, also we have an outstanding career center that is open to all students as well. We recommend our students to engage from day one with the career center to make sure when you graduate after 1 year in your master's, you're ready to find the job that you like. But when you come to Trinity, it's not just about the superb teaching that you will be provided with and the experience, academic experience. It's also many other supports that they help to make your life easier and also to develop many other skills that maybe you don't have the opportunity to do in the classroom. So we have from the Global Room, which is a center where all the international students can go anytime to look for support, so just to have a space to mingle around with the students from absolutely everywhere, the career guidance that I mentioned, the student union, and many other services. And this is something that is very, actually, I love it. This is one of the things that when you talk to alums and you ask them about their experience in Trinity, many of them, they don't even talk about the academics. They obviously enjoy that part, but they talk about the societies and the clubs where we are particularly good. Trinity has around 120 different societies and 50 sport clubs. If we talk about the sport, you can practice almost any sport that you can imagine, from a very beginning level to a almost professional level, from obviously basketball, soccer, but rugby, you will have fencing, you will have rowing, rock climbing, anything that you can mention, which is an opportunity to develop, if you like a sport, to develop that, but also to get to know people from everywhere and from many different backgrounds. And this is particularly the case if you want to join the societies. Societies, again, you have for any subject. We have a society for knitting, for traveling around Europe, the Law Society, the Entrepreneurial Society, the Indian Society, the Arabic Society. You have anything that you can think of. And if we don't have it, you can create a new society as well. But we have two societies that they are the oldest student societies in the world. They are debating societies. One is the Philosophical Society, the Phil, as we call it, and the Historical Society, or the HIST, that is the way that is known in Trinity. These societies, they have such a heavy weight, not only in Trinity, but in the world, that they invite people like the one that you are seeing in front of you in this slide, and they come to Trinity, invited by the students to talk to the students. So Joe Biden was there when he was vice president of Obama, and actually it was that day on campus. I also was the day that Channing Tatum was in Trinity invited by the students. I didn't know what was going on, but people were completely crazy, super excited about that. And I checked through my window, I saw that Channing Tatum was coming to campus. But people like Angela Merkel, Oliver Stone, Martin Scorsese, that you have in the picture as well, Kate Moss, many people from every different field. That is for you the opportunity to expose to knowledge and to an experience that may have nothing to do with the master that you are completing in Trinity. In Trinity, we have 3 faculties and 24 schools. We offer almost any program that you can imagine. If we talk about masters, we have 100 of them. Today, I'm not able to talk about all of them. You can get a feeling about the different themes that we have based on the name of the schools that you have in front of you. But I'm going to talk probably around 10, 11 of them today, just as a sample in different fields of things that you can study in Trinity as well. In Trinity, you can study from everything, from foundation for students, some students that they do Turkish diploma, they may have to do the foundation program, not all of them, but you can also apply for direct entry into our bachelor's degree. And when we come to master's, which is the main theme today, the masters typically are 12 months. They include a dissertation, which is this piece that has an important element of research, and you have many different options across all the 3 faculties. If you are really fully interested in research, then you can apply for our masters by research, which is 2 years, and then you can build on and do a PhD with one or two years more. PhDs typically are between 3 and 4 years. Let's talk about different programs that you can study as a master's student in Trinity. Starting by the Trinity School of Law, which is one that is very popular, particularly for Turkish students. Every year, we have many applicants that they come from Turkey to study law, and many of them that they are applying as well for the Jan Monet Scholarship. It's a European scholarship managed by the Turkish government and cover many programs in law and also in our business school. The School of Law was founded in 1740. It's the 6th oldest law school in the English-speaking world, and it's always around as well the top 100 best school of laws in the world. Has a very long tradition, and you can do many different programs. So you have them there. You can do from the classic LLM, or you can go for an LLM specializing in international and comparative law, and international and European business law, intellectual property and information technology law. And then we have a program that is a crossover between the business school and the School of Law, that is the Master in Law and Finance. The structure of the LLM, just as a sample, I'm not going to talk in much detail about all the programs, but this applies to some extent in many other programs in Trinity. To complete the master, you have to have 60 ECTS credits. In law, 60 of them, they are top modules, 3 modules per semester, and each one is worth 10 ECTS credits. For some programs, a student must choose module from a specific list, and each module is offered in one semester only and involves 20 hours of classroom. But then you have 30 ECTS credits that you will get through doing this final project, where you have also the opportunity to focus and specialize in something that you are particularly interested. In terms of these modules that you can choose, obviously you are not going to read everything here, but you can see we have offered a huge range of variety of different modules that you can take from. This is the crossover for law and finance. Again, it's 60 ECTS credits. And at the end, you have to do a research project that it has to be something that it links both of them. So the School of Law, you can choose between one of them. So you can decide at the end if you want to go more to the law side or to the business side. The mandatory modules are the ones that you have in front of you. Business ethics, corporate finance and corporate governance, EU financial service law, and investment theory. If you want to go to the Trinity Business School, also, they have many programs covered by the Jean Monnet Scholarship. You can choose many of them. Within management, you have international management and management as such. In finance, you can do finance, but you can also do financial risk management or the PG diploma in accounting. In marketing or digital marketing strategy, entrepreneurship, in the specializations as well is an option. Human resource management and operations and supply chain management. You have the classic MBA, and you can do business analytics, which is a very interesting program for those people that they want to follow a career in data, but they may not have the background in computer science for a master's in data science. And that program opened for a lot of opportunities in the data arena. This is as a sample that will illustrate that when you apply on top of the requirements for every program, you have to check what is the background that you require. For the business programs that you have in your left-hand side, you can see what is required in terms of the background. So if you need to have a degree before in business, or you don't need it, or you need to have a degree in that has an element in quantitative data for financial risk management, or if you need to have some working experience, as it is the case of the MBA, where you require between 3 and 5 years working experience. Computer science is in really high demand. I was telling you before that you have all the Googles, the Apples, the Twitter, these computer companies like Intel, for instance, which has, in fact, 5 research centers in the world, and one of them is in Trinity, and is considered the best performing Intel center in the world. Well, in computer science, we are extremely good and you have many opportunities, but if you are going to apply for this one, you have to apply very soon and be very competitive, because there are limited places and too many applications. You can specialize in data science, in future network system, in augmented and virtual reality, and in intelligent systems. But it's worth to explore other alternatives that give you career opportunities in similar fields that they are not under the computer science master umbrella. And the alternatives, as you can see there, is the MSc in Quantum Science and Technology that include physics, mathematics, computer science, or engineering as people that you need to have this type of background. If you have a quantitative background, the business analytic programs that I mentioned before. And if you have a non-quantitative background, you still have the opportunity to move into the data field if you apply for our diploma in applied social data science. Then you have our master in engineering. There you can do many different programs, mechanical engineering, biomedical engineering, music and media technologies, electronic information engineering, and within civil engineering, you can specialize in several things like environmental, sustainable energy engineering, structural and geotechnical, or transport engineering policy and planning. By the way, just to let you know that if you are specifically interested in master programs to do with engineering, computer science, or natural science, we will have a specific talk with IFT the next November 4th, where my colleagues from those schools will be presenting in more details all of these programs. This is a very good program that attracts students from a variety of backgrounds, the smart and sustainable cities, building tomorrow's cities through a transdisciplinary degree combining. That's what we say. So basically, if you have a background in urban geography and city planning, engineering and computer science, or ecology and environmental science, that's your program. And we will be very grateful if you keep working to make sure that our cities are ready for the 22nd century in a very nice way. That's a problem that we need a lot of people doing. We know all the problems that we have with the energy, and the energy science program is a program that focuses on alternatives to fossil fuel and nuclear energy. We are talking about energy economics and policy, natural resource management, sustainable energy technologies, and electricity and power electronics. If there is something that we know about in Trinity, it's about education. We have been educating and helping to educate people for more than 400 years. So if you have a vocation and you want to be an educator as well, there is endless opportunities. Within our Master of Education, you can see that there are 11 different strands that you can choose from drama in education to leadership and management in education, science education, psychology of education. So you have everything in there that you can specialize within the field of education as well. In humanities, you have many programs that they actually combine the technologies of the 21st century with to face up also the challenges that we have in the field of humanities. And this is one that is represented, this intersection of humanities, computing, and information management. It's our digital humanities program that applies cutting-edge methods to interrogate the most fundamental questions of a humanities subject. You can check if this program is for you if you want to understand cultural practices and tensions in the digital age and explore the virtual transmission of culture and heritage by and beyond museums, libraries, and archives. This is a program as well with the endless open opportunities, identities, and cultures of Europe. Identities for students that they are interested in philosophy, in sociology, is really at the heart of all these subjects. But you have the opportunity to specialize in that by see how actually our whole history is changing and how identities are changing all the time. And this gives you also the opportunity to have a field trip to go to Leuven in Belgium, to the Institute for Ireland in Europe, in that country. You have opportunities for internships as well in NGOs and cultural institutions, and we have research workshops as well with many high-profile speakers. And the core modules of that, they try to focus in theories of identity through specialists from the Trinity faculty as well. So for those interested in literature, history, sociology, gender studies, religion, visual arts, with a focus on Europe, that's your program. If we move to health science, you have many other programs that you can study here. I'm going to mention a few. The School of Medicine has been there for 300 years. The course open to students with a variety of backgrounds, so you don't have to have a medical background necessarily, but you can do 23 courses across 4 different areas. So in biomedical and pharmaceutical science, in health and healthcare, mental health, imagining a physical health, you have many different programs that you can do from something that is more focused, maybe in the clinical side, in the hospital, or if you want, for instance, to develop your career in a pharmaceutical company, as you know, we have many of them in Ireland, like all the Pfizer, Novartis, Foster certificate, they are here. So that can be something that you can explore if you want to follow a career in one of these companies. The School of Nursing is really highly ranked. It's the first in Ireland, but it's the 46th in the world. And you can specialize in many things as a master's student within the field of nursing. From a typical master in nursing to those ones more specialized, like this one in child health and well-being, mental health, dementia, community health, aging health, and well-being in intellectual disabilities. As I say, this is only a handful of the programs that we offer. We offer many, many more. In the chat now, I will answer all your questions, and also I will give you my email. So if there is any program you haven't seen there, but you're interested, more than likely we will have something that may be appealing to you. But we can take that conversation then in private if you want. But how do you apply? What is required to be accepted in a master in Trinity? The academic requirement, if you go to our website, will say 2.1 honors degree in the Irish system or equivalent. What is the equivalent in Turkey? We are talking around 3.0 GPA out of 4. Definitely, if you get a better GPA, it's even better, because some of the programs can be very competitive. So this is not a guarantee that you're going to get a place. This is just to make sure that you are positioned yourself to be considered. Mm-hmm. If you have less than 3.0, it will be complicated to get a place. You may give it a chance if you have your degree from a very prestigious university in Turkey, and you may have 2.8, 2.9. But it's better if you have 3.0. Some courses may require higher standards, and they can ask you to have a further test. If you want to study computer science, you will need to have a test. Some of the programs, like the Master in Education, you need to show a research proposal. Other programs may ask you to have an interview. So every time you have to check the specific program you want to apply for to see if there is an extra requirement on top of the academics. And all the programs as well will ask you for a minimum English language points. And we accept almost any official English certificate. If we talk about IELTS, you need to have at least 6.5 overall, although some programs may ask you for something higher. TOEFL 88. We accept as well Duolingo, that has to be 110, 160. We also accept Cambridge, we accept Pearson. And if you can prove that you have studied through the medium of English all your degree, you won't need to have any of these English exams. When do you apply? The application process opens the 1st of November. And the deadline to apply will be March, April, May, June. It depends on the program. So you have to check again the program you are interested in to make sure that you don't miss the deadline. However, it's very important to apply soon. We assess applications on a rolling basis. That means that first come, first serve. Let's say that you are a good student, that you have 3.0 GPA, and you apply in November, in December, you may have a better chance to get a place than if you're a genius with 4.0 GPA, but you apply in April for a program that in theory is open till June, because we may have no places at that stage. So one important requirement on top of the academics will be apply soon. You need to provide us with a transcript, with the predicted grades if you haven't finished yet, with a proof of English proficiency. You will need 2 letters of recommendation, typically from 2 academics from your university, and you have to submit as well a personal statement. This personal statement is 500 words, and what we are looking at is for students that they have done their research about Trinity, about the program that you want to study, and to tell us why do you think that you are a good fit for both, for Trinity and for the program. And don't forget to check the specific master you are applying for if they require any additional material. You can get a conditional offer. Let's say if you don't have your final grades, you have only the first few years of the university, because you still have to get your final grades, you still can get a conditional offer. The same if you don't have, for many programs, still your English exam. And now let's talk about money. The programs for masters, they can vary a lot, from around 13,000 euro and 25,000 euro and anything in between. You can find masters of all sorts. There are some exceptions that they are more expensive. For instance, the masters in dentistry, they tend to be over 40,000 euro. Or if you want to do the MBA with the business school, it's over 35,000 euro. But most of the rest of the programs, they are in that range, between 30 and 25,000 euro. The estimated living costs, including accommodation, food, utilities, commuting, we estimate that it's something like 15,000 euro, but it depends how good you are in terms of managing your finances as well. Scholarship. You need to take a look at them. This is only some of the most popular scholarship, but then you need to check with every single school to see if they have a specific scholarship that year. So if you're going to apply for a master in education, check the School of Education to see what they have available at the time that you apply. The Global Excellence Scholarship is managed by my office, the international office. You can get up to 5,000 euro that they are deduct from your fees. Typically you may get 3,000-4,000 euro, more than 5,000 euro. And the requirements is based on merit. So we will look at that you have good grades, and also based on diversity. In that case, you're in a good position because it's for international students outside of the European Union, so you will be good there. If you are thinking of programming to do with ETRIM, which is the School of Engineering and Natural Science, and also the School of Computer Science, ETRIM is the umbrella for these three schools, you have some specific scholarships, particularly for engineering and natural science program. They can be between 2,000 euro and 10,000 euro. If you want to learn more about these ones, remember to tune in for the talk by my colleagues the next November 4th here in IFT as well. The business school also, they have very popular scholarships, and they fund applicants with up to 10,000 euro per student, and you will get the scholarship with the offer. So if you get an offer from the business school, you will know if you are getting or not the scholarship as well. And that's everything from my side. Please make a note of my email, and if you want very specific questions or you want to have a private chat with me, I'll be more than happy to talk to you. So make a note about my email. And also, I strongly recommend you to scan this QR code by giving you a few details, like your name, the programs that you are interested in, and your email. We'll be in touch with you with relevant information. For instance, when the application opens, when you have a new scholarship, all these type of things that we consider that you may be interested in. So I'm going to count 5, and then I will remove this slide, so I will answer all the questions that you have left in the question in the box. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's stop sharing. Okay. I think disable screen. There you are. So I'm going to the question chat. And I've been told to start from the bottom. So Melissa, say, Antonio, first of all, thanks for your presentation. If it is possible, I want to learn about LLM programs and application dates for Trinity. I'm pretty sure I covered most of it, but in any case, the application opens in November, and then you have to check when it will close. Typically it's June, but sometimes the LLM programs, they can close earlier. So check them out. And if you want, send me an email. I'll be happy to help you, and also to put you in touch with the School of Law, that they are extremely helpful. Irmak, hello, I am an English student and I wanted to ask if there are many funding opportunities for this field, Also, is it possible to do MPhil in literature and then a PhD instead of directly applying to master literature and PhD? Okay. First of all, we have funding, some like the Global Excellence. I told you you can apply. Then you should check as well in the School of English if they have any other. And typically, when you have an honors degree, you don't have to apply for a master. You can apply directly for a PhD. However, many times when you do first, if you want to do the PhD in Trinity, considering that you are not a student here, if you study an MPhil first, that will give you an opportunity, so you do the master first, the Toastmaster, to get to know many professors and academics, because the main thing for doing a PhD, is to find the professor that wants to be your supervisor. So if you do your master in literature in Trinity, you will have a full year to see what field you are interested in and to discover actually the opportunities that you have in Trinity as well. But you can do it either way. You can do the master in literature and then go into the PhD, or you can apply for a PhD or a master by research directly if you are very lucky and really good and find the supervisor. Gamse, I want to ask PhD opportunities at Trinity College. So this is the same probably in most of the universities. What you have to do is, Gamse, to go to our website to do your research about the research that you want to do and figure out what academics they are following the things that you are interested in. And it's a matter just of try with many of them, because you never know. What happens is the academics, they are very limited, not just in terms of money, but also in terms of the time that they can allocate to a PhD student. So it's a matter to academically seduce a supervisor to see if you can work with her or with him. And also it's important as well, if you are coming with funding, to let them know, because that may give you a little bit of an angle, so they will look at you in a nicer way. But if you want to, we don't provide much support in my offer to PhD students, because we cannot actually tell the academic to take you, but we can give you some tips. So if you go to Gamse, send me just an email and I'll send you a little brochure where you can follow up some of the tips that we give to prospect PhD students. Merv Gilmas, can we do internships? Do you have any specific partner companies for internships? We have partnership with many, many different companies. We don't guarantee for most of programs internships, so it's something that the students, they have to be proactive. However, we are linking all the time with the industry. For instance, if you study engineering, we have, I think, twice a year, a big fair of companies coming to campus to offer internship and recruit a student from Trinity. And that's very similar in many other fields. So you have to check what you have to study and then to make sure that you can capitalize on the connection that the school has already with the industry. Yes, Mustafa, in terms of information about engineering master programs, I give you an outline. So it's the headings of the program that we offer. You have seen them in the presentation, but I strongly recommend you to tune in the November 4th, when my colleagues from the School of Engineering will keep you a lot of information in detail about the School of Engineering and the programs that they offer. Ese is saying, do international students have work permit after graduation in EU countries? So I don't know about other EU countries, but what I tell you is, in Ireland, if you complete your master's, you're entitled to apply for 2 years stay back visa. Mm-hmm. So when you have 2 years to look for a job in Ireland. Yeah? Another thing is, if in the future you stay in Ireland for 5 years working, you can become an Irish citizen, so you're a European citizen and you can do whatever you want. But I don't know, because every single European country is different. I know that the opportunities in that sense, that the generosity of Ireland giving these 2 years opportunities is very good. But if you're interested in other countries, you will have to research yourself. What are requirements for applying for bachelor degree? Today is more focused on master's. So if you send me an email, I will be more than happy to give you the requirements. And you in that email, you should tell me, what is the program that you want to study? And what is the curriculum? So if you're studying in an international school, if you're completing the lycée diplomacy, what type of curriculum you do. I will tell you everything about our bachelor degrees. How long does it take application process after sending our documents? Okay, in the case of the master's, undergraduate is different. For master's, it can be around 6 weeks. But it depends on the program. Some programs, they are very quick, and some of them, they take a little bit longer. Because the head of the department and the head of the discipline, of the master, they are heavily involved in the process. It's not only the admission office. So depending on the master you're going to apply for, they are quicker or slower, and some of them, they process application differently. So if you get in touch with me, I will be able to follow up with you. And when you submit everything, I will be able to get a feeling of how long you should wait. Do you have any summer session of advanced English for high school students, such as creative writing, comparative literature? For high school students, we have some summer camps that you should check. The one we have called the Walton Club, that is more about science. Then we have another about performing arts. I don't think we have one about the English, which is a pity, because you have so many afterwards. So obviously, if you have been in the presentation from the very beginning, you heard that we are the University of Oscar Wilde, Samuel Beckett, Jonathan Swift, Bram Stoker, Sally Rooney, the scripters actually of Game of Thrones, the famous TV show, both of them, they met in Trinity doing a master's in literature. But we don't have anything available for high school students. And I believe I reached the end of all the questions. I want to thank all of you for being at the presentation today. Don't forget that we have another one the November 4th, focus on problems in engineering, in natural science, and in computer science. And to say that I'm looking forward to receiving any of your emails. So if you have any other question that comes to your head in the future, in the next few days, or you want to just to have a private chat about what you want to study, you are more than welcome to contact me anytime. So thank you very much to IFT. Thank you to all of you for being here today. And don't hesitate to keep in touch. Thanks a lot, Zeynep. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much for your fantastic presentation, Antonio, and also for your answers. You covered all of the questions.
Thanks to you, Zeynep, and see you soon. And hopefully see you, all of you, either in Trinity Campus or somewhere in Tokyo.
Yes, thank you. Also, thanks for, I would like to thank for the participants in Turkish as well. Katıldığınız için teşekkür ederiz arkadaşlar. Trinity College Dublin ile ilgili diğer sorularınızı Antonio'ya sorabilirsiniz. Aynı zamanda 4 Kasım'daki webinarımızda da sorabilirsiniz. Umarım sizin için de faydalı bir webinar olmuştur. Yarınki webinarlarımızda görüşmek üzere. Thank you very much again, Antonio. It was a pleasure to have you in IFT Talks.
Thanks to all of you. Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.